We just soak this sanctuary in the blood of Jesus. Holy angels of the living God, come and gather with us this afternoon on this mountain. You are the Lord, that is your name. You will never share your glory with anyone. You will never share your glory with anybody. Almighty God, that is your name. Lord, that is your name. You will never share your glory with anyone. You will never share your glory with anybody. Almighty God, that is your name. You are the Lord, that is your name. You will never share your glory with anyone. Share your glory with anybody. Almighty God, that is your name. You are the Lord, that is your name. You will never share your glory with anyone. You will never share your glory with anybody. Almighty God, that is your name. In terms of singing, you are worthy, oh. You're worthy, you are worthy, oh Lord. You're worthy, you are worthy, oh Lord. You're worthy, you are worthy. Your children are saying, you are worthy, oh Lord. You're worthy, you are worthy, oh Lord. You are worthy, Lord. Jehovah, you are worthy, Lord. It shall be. King of kings, you are worthy, Lord. I want the Lord. Jehovah, you are worthy, Lord. You are ancient of days, you are worthy, Lord. You are worthy, Lord. She now worthy, Lord. You are worthy, Lord. Joy overflows, joy overflows in my heart. I say, sing a new song to the Lord. Joy overflows, joy overflows in my heart. I say, sing a new song to the Lord. I will praise your name. I will worship you. Glory, hallelujah. Sing a new song to the Lord. Sing a new song to the Lord. Joy overflows, joy overflows in my heart. I say, sing a new song to the Lord. Joy overflows in my heart. I say, sing a new song to the Lord. For I will praise your name. I will worship you. Glory, hallelujah. Sing a new song to the Lord. Sing a new song to the Lord. You are the mighty God, the great I am. Hallelujah, hallelujah. You are the mighty God, the great I am. Hallelujah, hallelujah. You are the Lord of Lords, the King of Kings. Hallelujah, hallelujah. You are the mighty God, the great I am.
Hallelujah, hallelujah. Ha.
Jehovah, you are the most high. Jehovah, you are the most high. El Shaddai, you are Jehovah. Jehovah, Adonai, you are Jehovah, you are the most high. Jehovah Jireh, you are Jehovah, you are the most high. Jehovah Elohim, you are Jehovah, you are the most high. Jehovah Shekinah, you are Jehovah. Jehovah Shaddai, you are Jehovah, you are.
All I require for life, God has given me.
says I am, what he says I am, what he says I am, I know who I am, I know who God says I am, what he says I am. When he says I am, I know who I am. I'm walking in power, I'm walking in miracle, I live a life of favor. I know who I am. Oh, I'm walking in power, I'm walking in miracle, I live a life of favor. Everybody shout it, oh. I know who I am. To see now, you see His glory. I know who I am. Take a look at me, I'm a wonder. No matter what you see now, you see His glory. Everybody shout and joy. I know who I am. Yabashaka Tiri Baba. I want you to sing like this. I am tired of the vanity. Holy Ghost lifts me up, Holy Ghost lifts me up. I am tired of that vanity. Holy Ghost, Holy Ghost lifts me higher. I am tired of that vanity. Holy Ghost, listen. I am tired of my problems. Holy Ghost of them now, Holy Ghost of them now. I am tired of my problems. Holy Ghost, Holy Ghost, Holy Ghost of them now. I am tired of my problems. Holy Ghost, I'm tired of my failures. I am tired of my failures. Holy Ghost, give me success. Holy Ghost, give me success. Holy Ghost, give me success. I am tired of failure. Holy Ghost, Holy Ghost, give me success. I am tired of my failures. Holy Ghost, Holy Ghost, break my yoke. Masika riba riba suri baba kasha daba. Iba kusa ina puri baba kasa dani munda. Holy Ghost, break my yoke. Holy Ghost, break my yoke. Holy Ghost, break my yoke. Holy Ghost, I need the change by fire. Holy Ghost, I need the change by fire. I say, Holy Ghost, I need the change by fire. I need the change. I say, Holy Ghost, I need a chain by fire. I need fire pursue them, fire pursue them, fire pursue them. Fire pursue them, fire pursue them, fire pursue them. Witches and wizards, opposing powers, carrying powers, serpentine powers, idol powers, pursue them now, now. Fire pursue the fire pursue the Holy Ghost fire. Fire pursue the fire pursue the fire pursue the Holy Ghost fire. 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 Check. I cover myself with the blood of Jesus. I cover myself with the blood of Jesus. I cover this prayer meeting with the blood of Jesus. I cover my household with the blood of Jesus. I cover my spouse with the blood of Jesus. I cover my children with the blood of Jesus. I cover all that I have with the blood of Jesus. As I go into this spiritual spiritual warfare this afternoon. As I go into this spiritual battle this afternoon, every stain of sin in my life be washed away by the blood of Jesus. In the name of Jesus, every stain of sin in my life be washed away by the blood of Jesus. As I go into today's battles, as I go into this afternoon's warfare, blood of Jesus, wash away every stain of sin in my life, in my wife's life, in my children's lives, in this church, in the name of Jesus. Blood of Jesus, wash me. Blood of Jesus, wash me. What can make me whole again? Nothing but the blood of Jesus. What can make me white as snow? Nothing but the blood of Jesus. Precious is that flow that makes me white as snow. No other fount I know, nothing but the blood of Jesus. As I go into this spiritual warfare, I overcome the forces of darkness by the power in the blood of Jesus. In the name of Jesus, as I go into this spiritual battle, as I go into this spiritual warfare, I overcome the forces of darkness by the power in the blood of Jesus. For it is written in the book of Revelation chapter 12 verse 11 that we overcame the enemy by the blood of the Lamb and by the words of our testimonies, and we love not our lives even unto the death. Yes, as I go into this spiritual battle, as I go into this spiritual warfare, I overcome forces of darkness by the power in the blood of Jesus. I overcome the forces of darkness by the power in the blood of Jesus. I overcome the forces of darkness by the power in the blood of Jesus. For in Jesus' name we pray. As I go into today's battle, I wear the garment of the blood of Jesus. In the name of Jesus, as I go into today's battles, I wear the garment of the blood of Jesus. My wife and my children wear the garment of the blood of Jesus. We wear the garment of fire. We wear the garment of the blood of Jesus. We wear the garment of fire. We wear the garment of the blood of Jesus. We wear the garment of fire. Yes, as I go into the battle today, I wear the garment of the blood of Jesus. I wear the garment. Oh yes. Of fire in the name of Jesus. For in Jesus' name we pray. We are going to shout and say, blood of Jesus. Blood of Jesus. Arise in your power and scatter every congregation of darkness that is enchanting against me. In the name of Jesus, blood 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 of Jesus, arise in your power. I say scatter every congregation of dark powers, every congregation of witches and wizards, every congregation of occult powers, every congregation of marine powers, every congregation of serpentine powers, every congregation of idol worshippers, enchanting against me, enchanting against my family, enchanting against this church. Blood of Jesus, arise your power and scatter them. For in Jesus' name we pray. Somebody's hearing my voice right now. There is an enchantment that is going on against your career, against your job, against your business. You are going to shout like this. Yeah? Blood of Jesus! Blood of Jesus! Arise in your power! Scatter every enchantment of darkness! I sign against my career in the name of Jesus. Blood of Jesus! Blood of Jesus! Jesus, arise your power, scatter every enchantment of darkness that gets against my career, that gets my job. That gathered against my business. That gathered against my finances. That gathered against my investments. That gathered against my marriage. That gathered against my wife. That gathered against my home. That gathered against my children. Blood of Jesus scattered them. Blood of Jesus scattered them. Every enchantment of darkness that gathered against me and my family. Blood of Jesus, arise your power and scatter them. Arise your power and scatter them. Arise your power, yes. Father, Jesus, may we pray. You are going to pray like this. Say, as I go into this spiritual warfare, every satanic gang up against my destiny, against my career, against my marriage, against my wife, against my children, against my business, against my job, against my investments, against my finances, scatter by fire. Scatter by fire, scatter by thunder, scatter by fire, yes. Every satanic gang up against my marriage, against my home, against my wife, against my children, against my investments, against my business, against my career, against my job, I say scatter in the name of Jesus. Scatter by fire, scatter by thunder, scatter by fire, scatter by thunder, scatter by fire, scatter by thunder, scatter by fire, yes. They must scatter. By the power and the blood of Jesus. God, Jesus, they will pray. Wherever you are, just lay your right hand on your head. And you are going to shout like this. Every source of afflictions in my body, catch fire, burn to ashes. In the name of Jesus, every source of afflictions in my body, in my blood, in my water, in my flesh, in my bones, I say catch fire, burn to ashes, 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 yes. Every source of cancer, every source of diabetes, every source, yes, of Parkinson's disease, every source of liver cirrhosis, every source of gallbladder, oh yes, every source of fibroid, every source of cyst, oh yes, every source of bronchitis, every source, oh yes, of brain problems, I say catch fire, burn to ashes, by the power in the blood of Jesus, catch fire, burn to ashes, 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 yes, lakasha katari baba, break it, take it. Fine, Jesus, please minister heaven. Please minister. Likasikate, likasikate, don't know how to fall down, don't know how to fall down. Rikasataraba, leprakasataraba. Yes, sir, let us sit down, let us sit down. Ripasatarababa, hey, break your secretary. Yes, for Jesus, then we pray. The next prayer we are going to pray, we are going to shout like this. Every poison of darkness,
every poison of darkness
in my blood, that is causing diseases, that is causing sickness, be burnt to ashes by the fire of the Holy Ghost in the name of Jesus. Every poison of darkness in my blood, yes, in my wife's blood, in my children's blood, in the blood of members of my family, that is causing diseases, that is causing sicknesses in our bodies, I say be burnt to ashes by the fire of the Holy Ghost. Be burnt to ashes by the fire of the Holy Ghost. Be burnt to ashes. Yes, burn them to ashes. 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 Yes. Poison of darkness in your blood. Must catch fire. 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 For in Jesus' name they have caught fire. Amen. Praise the Lord. Father, we bless your holy name. You are a wonderful God. It's a wonderful thing to know you, O Lord. Thank you because you are our God and we are your people. Thank you because you are the God that answered by fire. And even already since we started, you have started answering us by fire. And thank you, Father, because everyone that has come here today, those that are still coming, and those that are listening to us, everyone we have uncommon testimony in the name of Jesus. Everyone we have uncommon breakthrough in the name of Jesus. For in Jesus' name we are prayed. Praise the Lord. Let us sit down. God bless you in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Very quickly, we are looking at the topic. The monitoring evil eyes. Monitoring evil eyes. Praise the Lord. Amen. Eyes that are monitoring for evil. Let us open our Bibles to Proverbs. Amen. The monitoring evil eyes. I want you to shout where you are sitting down. Say, every evil eye.
Every evil eye.
Monitoring my star.
Monitoring my
star. Somebody is hearing the sound of my voice shouting loud.
Monitoring my star.
Every monitoring eye, every evil eye, monitoring my star, monitoring my star, monitoring my wife's star, monitoring my children's stars, monitoring my sibling's stars, monitoring my parents' stars, monitoring the stars of MFM-Tampa, Florida. Go blind my fire, 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 go blind my yes. I want you to shout it. Every evil eye. Monitoring your star, monitoring your destiny, monitoring your marriage, monitoring your career, monitoring your job, monitoring your business. I say, go blind by fire, go blind by fire, go blind by fire, go blind by fire, go blind by fire,
go blind by fire, go blind by fire.
In Jesus' name, we have gone blind. Don't worry, that evil eye that is looking at you and monitoring your progress from your father's house shall suddenly go blind by fire tonight in the name of Jesus. Yes. Shall suddenly go blind by fire right now. Yes. In the name of Jesus. Let us say that. God bless you in the name of Jesus. Proverbs chapter 23 verse 6. Eat thou not bread. That means do not eat bread of him that hath an evil eye. So there is what they call the evil eye. That some people have an evil eye. Somebody is here. You are going to shout it like this. All the evil eyes surrounding me, go blind by the power and the blood of Jesus. In the name of Jesus, all the evil eyes surrounding me, surrounding my wife, surrounding my children, surrounding the church, go blind by the power in the blood of Jesus. Go blind. Jesus. For in Jesus' name we pray. The Bible says, neither desire thou his dainty meats. Amen. The Bible says, eat thou not the bread of him that hath an evil eye. Neither desire thou his dainty meats. Amen. Somebody is here, shout this prayer. Lay your right hand on your stomach. It is our hour of deliverance power. Say, every meat of darkness that I have swallowed on the table of the wicked. Every meat of darkness I have swallowed on the table of the wicked. I vomit in my fire. 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 Every drink of darkness that I, my wife, and my children have consumed and swallowed on the temple of the wicked. Yes, we vomit them as fire. For Jesus' name we pray. God bless you. Sit down. I said today we shall be looking deeper into the mystery of spiritual warfare. And if you are listening to us, we are seizing this opportunity to invite you to come and worship with us in Mountain of Fire, Miracles Ministries, Tampa, Florida. Yes, where deliverance prayer is offered on daily basis. Praise the Lord. I say there is a need for us to understand these deep spiritual issues. They are very deep spiritual issues. I say we need to understand them if we want to be victorious in spiritual warfare. Somebody is listening to the sound of my voice right now. You have been defeated on the battlefield of life. But I pray for you today that the Lord will empower you to become victorious once again in the name of Jesus. Amen. I said, because how do you fight a power? How do you fight a power that is looking at you, that is monitoring you, and you cannot see them? Praise the Lord. A power is looking at you. A power is, you know, monitoring you, and you cannot see them. You are going to pray that you say, oh Lord, open my spiritual eyes to see the unseen. Jesus, in the name of Jesus, oh God, my Father, open my spiritual eyes, open my wife's spiritual eyes, open my children's spiritual eyes, open the spiritual eyes of members of this church, so that we can see the unseen, in the name of Jesus, so that we can begin to see the invisible by the power in the blood of Jesus. Amen. I said, even though spiritual things tend to be invisible. Spiritual things tend to be invisible. They are actually physical occurrences. Even though spiritual things tend to be invisible, you cannot see them, but they are actually happening physically. The only reason why we cannot see them with our naked eyes is just because of the limitation of the power of our eyes. Somebody said, just put your right hand on your face and shout like this. Say, every limitation to my spiritual vision, clear away by fire in the name of Jesus. Every limitation of my spiritual vision, every cataract of my spiritual vision, clear away by fire, 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 clear away by fire. For in Jesus' name, you know, Proverbs 28:19 says, where there is no vision, said the people perish. Where you cannot see, you are done for. Amen. Because a lot of things will be happening in your life and you cannot see. Of the wicked powers that surround me in the name of Jesus. Oh Lord, my Father, open my eyes, open my wife's eyes, open my children's eyes, open the eyes of members of this church to see the atrocities of the wicked powers, the wicked personalities that surround us. For in Jesus' name we pray. I say, I've heard a lot of people say there is nothing like spirituality. Amen. Praise the Lord. You know, Hosea 4:6 says, he said, my people perish for lack of knowledge. Amen. I said, they will even ask you to prove it. Somebody will come and meet you and say, you said there is spirituality. You said there is spirit realm. Come and prove it. I said, thank God for microscopes. Thank God for magnifying lenses. Amen. And most especially electron microscopes. A lot of skeptics would have won the argument that bacteria, viruses, and fungi don't exist, simply because they could not be seen with the naked eyes. Thank God that there are microscopes. Thank God that there are magnifying lenses. We cannot see viruses, bacteria, and some fungi with our naked eyes. But we're able to see them under magnifying glasses. We're able to see them under microscopes. We are able to see them especially under the electron microscope. If those instruments are not existing, some people would have said, there is nothing like virus. There is nothing like bacteria. Amen. There are a lot of spiritual battles going on in the life of a man or woman, even though they are suffering the physical consequences, just like somebody that has a bacterial infection. He's having pains, he's having problems, but he does not know what is wrong with him. All he knows is that he's going through discomfort. It is when he goes to the doctor, doctor takes sample of blood, sample of urine, thank God they don't take offices anymore. Praise the Lord. And they take it to the lab. By the time they culture the solution, they now see that there is a bacteria, or there are bacteria, or there are viruses in the sample of the fluid from that man's body. Praise the Lord. And so even though they are suffering the physical consequences, they still find it very hard to believe that these problems are spiritual. Praise the Lord. Somebody is hearing me. Is hearing the sound of my voice. I want you to pray this prayer. Say, powers hiding in the spirit realm to afflict my soul. Can you shout it again? Yes. Your head has gone down in the name of Jesus. Powers hiding in the spirit realm to afflict my soul, to afflict my wife's soul, to afflict my children's souls, to afflict the souls of members of the church. Your head has gone. Die in the name of Jesus. 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 For in Jesus' name we pray. Because what is spirituality? Ability of wicked powers, ability of wicked personalities to attack their victim remotely, to attack their victims without coming in physical contact with them. So we said they do it spiritually. The Bible itself confirmed to us that there are visible and invisible things, visible and invisible powers. Let us look at Colossians chapter 1. Hallelujah. Amen. Colossians chapter 1 verse 16. The Bible says, for by him were all things created. God created everything. Amen. That are in heaven and that are in earth. Look at what he said. Visible and invisible. There is a sister listening to the sound of my voice. You are going to pray like this. Every invisible power attacking my destiny. Every invisible power attacking my destiny. Appear in the name of Jesus. Every invisible power attacking my destiny, attacking my wife's destiny, attacking my children's destinies. Appear, die, appear, die, appear, die, appear, die, appear, die, appear, die. For in Jesus' name, they are dead. Amen. They are hiding in the invisible, but they are carrying out physical havoc. Praise the Lord. So lesson number one. I said, so what are monitoring eyes? What are monitoring eyes? From that question, there are three prominent words. Amen. He said, the monitoring evil eyes. There is monitoring there. There is evil there. And there is eyes. The eye provides vision of things that are visible. That's what the eye does. Amen. I happen to be a physics student those days. Amen. For you to see anything, there must be a reflection of light on that object. And is now reflected into your eyes. Praise the Lord. And so part of the eyes now begin to function for you to see the object. Praise the Lord. So eyes provide vision of things that are visible. With the eyes, you can see what is going on around you. Just like you are looking at me now, praise the Lord, you can see what is going on around you. With the eyes, you can tell whether there is darkness or there is light. Praise the Lord. That's the reason why those that have sight challenge, praise the Lord, it is dark for them all the time. But I pray, if there's anyone that is hearing the sound of my voice right now and they have blind sight, let their eyes open by fire in the name of Jesus. I say Ephata in the name of Jesus. I say Ephata to those eyes. I command those eyes to open by the power in the blood of Jesus. By the power that opened the eyes of blind Bartimaeus.
I command your eyes to open in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
I say, but for the purpose of this message, we shall be talking about the spiritual eye. The Lord will give you spiritual eyes. In the name of Jesus. Say, oh Lord, give me spiritual eyes that can see into the spiritual. That can see into the spiritual. And that's the reason why a lot of people are suffering. Because they cannot see into the spiritual. They cannot see the powers, the personality, the spirits that are tormenting them. Praise the Lord. The eye that can see what the physical eye cannot see. Amen. Amen. Is the spiritual eyes. You may call it a man or a woman's spiritual lens. The eye that can see what the naked eye cannot see. You can call that eye the spiritual lens or the spiritual microscope of a man or a woman. Praise the Lord. Because with a physical microscope, it can see what the naked eye cannot see. So your spiritual eye can actually be called your spiritual microscope. Lay your right hand on your face again. You are going to shout like this. Jesus, hold up my father as from today, empower my spiritual microscopes so that I can see into the invisible, I can see into the spiritual in the mighty name of Jesus. Amen. I say, or what we often refer to as the inner spiritual eyes. Amen. The inner spiritual eye is very powerful because it can see all that is going on in the spirit realm. You can see. Praise the Lord. One of the reasons why you can have a dream is because your inner spiritual eye or your spiritual microscope is at work. Does it not amaze you? You will sleep tonight. Amen. And some few days later, you will sleep tonight, have a dream, see a particular scenery, see a particular situation in your dream, and few days later you will see the same thing in the physical. That's what we're talking about. I said this is what people don't have or have not developed that makes them to deny the spirituality of life. Beloved, I've met a lot of people in my life that told me that they have never had a dream before since they were born. Somebody is hearing the sound of my voice. Lay your right hand on your eyes again and say, powers! Attacking the power of my vision. And my dreams. Powers! Attacking the power of my vision. And my dreams. Fall down and down. Fall down and down. Yes, powers attacking. Yes, the power of my visions, the power of my dreams, fall down and down in the name of Jesus. Amen. The Bible said, it said, where there is no vision, the people perish. So if you cannot see into the spirit realm and they are looking at you, every step you take, they are watching you. When you wake up, they see you. When you went into your bathroom, they saw you. When you dressed up, they were looking at you. When you went into your car, they were looking at you. When you were driving, where you went, they saw you. They can attack all the every step, every stage of your movement. Amen. Somebody say this prayer. Say, powers from my father's house. That is the reason why you have been having all the problems you are having. Because everywhere they go, they check with you. They can see you on their mirror. Amen. They can see you with their spiritual eyes. Say, powers! Monitoring my life for evil. From my father's house. Die! In the name of Jesus. my life, monitoring my wife's life, monitoring my children's lives. Oh yes, for evil from our father's houses, and from our mother's houses, from our in-laws' houses. Oh yes, from our place of birth, I command you to die by the power in the blood of Jesus. Die by the power in the blood of Jesus. For in Jesus' name we pray. Let us look at some examples of those that had the spiritual eyes and used it, even in the Bible. Number one is Adam and Eve. Even though it put them in trouble, it was when they ate the food that their eyes opened. The eyes that opened when Adam and Eve ate the forbidden fruit in the Garden of Eden is what you refer to as the spiritual eye. Amen. And let me read the scripture. The Bible says when the serpent went to her and took her to the tree, the Bible says it was pleasing to the eye, isn't it? Genesis chapter 5. Genesis chapter 3 from verse 5. Genesis 3 from 5. For God doth know that in the day ye eat thereof, then your eyes shall be opened. Which eye? And ye shall be as gods, knowing good and evil. You can see the power of the spiritual eye. It enables you to know good and evil. You will even be like God, because you can see what is going on, you know, in the spirit realm. You can see what is going on around you that is not physically available. Praise the Lord. Amen. I said, this is because they had their physical eyes opened before they ate the fruit. Look at this, verse 6. And when the woman saw that the tree was good for food, how they went with her eye. And when the woman saw that the tree was good for food, and that it was pleasant to the eyes, at that time it was still the physical eyes. And the tree to be desired, to make one wise, she took of the fruit thereof, and did eat, and gave also unto her husband with her, and he did eat. Look at verse 7. And the eyes of them both were opened. Ah! Say, oh Lord! Shout it again! Shout it again! Somebody is hearing the sound of my voice. Shout it! Powers attacking my spiritual eyes. Yeah. Amen. You are hearing me. Whenever you dream, you forget. Whenever you dream, you don't remember. Whenever you dream, you just remember partially. What is happening is that your spiritual eyes can see, but there's a power that is attacking it, so that the memory of the spiritual eyes can be erased. Lay your right hand on your eyes again. Say, powers! Erasing the memory of my spiritual eyes. Somebody says, shouting loud. You are always dreaming and you are forgetting. Shouting loud. Yes. Powers erasing the memory of my spiritual eyes, of my spiritual vision. Die in the name of Jesus. Die in the name of Jesus. Die in the name of Jesus. Yes. That's the reason why you cannot dream. That is the reason why you are dreaming and you are forgetting. That is the reason why you dream. You can only remember part of it. For in Jesus' name we pray. I say this confirmed to us that there are physical eyes and there are spiritual eyes. Another example was Elisha and Gehazi. Praise the Lord. If you look at Numbers chapter 2, if you look at 2 Kings chapter 5, 2 Kings chapter 5, hallelujah. Amen. 2 Kings chapter 5 from verse 25 to 27. Very interesting scripture. The Bible says, and he said unto him, went not my heart with thee? When the man turned again from his chariot to meet thee, Naaman came to Elisha for the cleansing of his leprosy. He now gave a gift to the prophet, but the prophet rejected it. And Gehazi, his servant, ran after Naaman and collected it. And when he came back, he was lying to Elisha. How can you lie to a man that has spiritual eyes? Praise the Lord. Amen. Is it a time to receive money and to receive garments and only vineyards and vineyards and sheep and oxen and men servants and men servants? The leprosy therefore of Naaman shall cleave unto thee and unto thy seed forever. I want somebody to pray. So every gift I've ever collected in my life,
every gift I've ever collected in my life
that has brought affliction upon my soul, Jesus, every gift I have ever collected in my life, that my wife and my children have ever collected in their lives, that has brought afflictions upon our souls, I say catch fire, I say die, I say catch fire, I say die, I say catch fire, I say die. For in Jesus' name we pray. You know, there are some gifts we call Greek gifts. They are problematic gifts. Some children of darkness, some agents of darkness, they will dedicate a particular gift in their cover and they will give it to you. And you will not know you collect it. If Jesus is not in your life, if Jesus is not in your life, whatever affliction they pronounce against you will fall upon you. Just like it happened between Elisha and Gehazi. Praise the Lord. I say, what followed Gehazi when he went after Naaman, the Syrian captain, to collect the gift that destroyed him? Was the spiritual eyes of Elisha. We are going to shout like this. I mean, we are at the end of the year now. All manner of gifts is going to be coming. You are going to raise up your two hands. Say, by the power and the blood of Jesus. Shout it louder than that. I will not collect the gift that will destroy me. In the name of Jesus. By the power in the blood of Jesus, I, my wife and my children, my parents, my siblings, my family members of this church, we will not collect any gift that will destroy us in the name of Jesus. If there's any power, any spirit, any personality that is planning to give me and my family any gift that will destroy us, Father, let it backfire. Let it backfire. Let it backfire. Let it backfire. For in Jesus' name we pray. There was also the example of Elisha and the king of Syria. And that was a very, very interesting story. Praise the Lord. In 2 Kings chapter 6, from verse 8 to 12. Amen. Look at the power of the eye. And this actually explains to us how they monitors, how the agents of darkness from their cover monitor their victims. Praise the Lord. Shout this prayer again. So, powers monitoring me from any cover.
Monitoring me from any cover.
Can you shout it again? Yes.
Monitoring me from any cover.
Shout it louder than that.
Monitoring me from any
cover. Powers monitoring me and my family from any cover. Catch fire with your cover. In the name of Jesus, catch fire with your cover. For in Jesus' name we pray. From verse 8, the Bible says, amen. Then the king of Syria warred against Israel and took counsel with his servants, saying, in such and such a place shall be my camp. The king of Syria was fighting with the king of Israel, and he was telling them, this is where I'm going to, you know, camp to fight them. And the man of God sent unto the king of Israel, that is Elisha, say, beware that thou pass not such a place, for thither the Syrians are come down. You can see why it is good to have spiritual eyes. So that when they are laying booby traps for you, when they are setting nets, you know, snares for you, you can see it in your vision. Sometimes you want to go somewhere, God, heaven has already opened your spiritual eyes. In your dream, in your vision, you can see the danger of where you are going. Praise the Lord. And the king of Israel said to the place which the man of God told him, and warned him off and saved himself there. Not once, not twice. Praise the Lord. Look at the power of the spiritual eye. They can stay anywhere. Amen. I said Elisha was in a vision of everything going on in the palace of the king of Syria with his spiritual eyes, even though he was not in Syria, he was in Israel. Amen. With the power of the spiritual eye, location or distance is never a barrier. Amen. Anyone that has power, amen, anyone that has powerful sense of spiritual eyes can see you anywhere you may be located on the surface of the earth. With a set of powerful spiritual eyes, wherever you are, they can see you. I said this is why it is very easy for agents of darkness to see and monitor anyone they want to attack. Praise the Lord. Anywhere he or she may be in this world. Praise the Lord. There was also the story of Elijah and the servants. Of course, the king of Syria got upset that prophet Elisha was revealing his secrets, and he decided to send a detachment of soldiers to arrest him. You know, this is what happens sometimes. Sometimes when you now begin to see them, they begin to attack you. They attack the vision. They attack anything you have because you can see them. So the king of Syria, of course, sent soldiers, praise the Lord, to arrest Elisha. But the unfolding drama that ensued further affirmed to us the power of the spiritual eyes. We are still looking at 2 Kings chapter 6. Amen. We now look from 13 to 17. The Bible says, and he said, go and spy where he is. That is the monitoring. Go and spy where he is. We are going to pray like this. Say, any power. Satanic power that is sending any evil agent to monitor me, to monitor my wife, to monitor my children. I command you to die. 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 For in Jesus' name we pray. And he said, go and spy where he is. That is the monitoring evil eyes. And that I may send and fetch him. And that it was told him, saying, behold, he is a daughter. Praise the Lord. Therefore sent in thither horses and chariots and a great host, and they came by night and compassed the city about. Somebody is hearing the sound of my voice. Shout this out. Say, powers! Gathering to attack me in the night. Can you shout it again? Every night you sleep, they attack you. Can you shout it again? In the night, blood of Jesus, arise in your power, scatter them, 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 yes, in the name of Jesus. Powers, God bring to attack me, to attack my wife, to attack my children, to attack my parents, to attack my siblings, to attack my relatives, to attack members of this church in the night. Blood of Jesus, arise in your power and scatter them. For in Jesus' name we pray. The Bible says, and compass the city about. They came in the night. Every power attacking you in the night shall somersault and die.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus. And when the servant of the man of God was risen early, his servant woke up early and gone forth. And behold, and horse compassed the city both with horses and chariots. So the servant woke up very early and saw them, and he was afraid. And the servant said unto him, alas, my master, how shall we do? Mm-hmm. When you cannot see, you'll be afraid. Sometimes you are just afraid of what you cannot see. When you can see something, you will not be afraid. A car is about to have an accident. You cannot see it. Everybody is running. Of course, you'll be running without seeing what is pursuing you. But when you see the direction of where the car is going, and you know that it's not facing your direction, of course, you are not going to be afraid. Praise the Lord. And he answered, fear not. That's Elisha. For they that be with us are more than they that be with them. I'm sure the servant wants to look and say, what is wrong with this, my master? The only two of us. And you are saying that those that are with us are more than them that are against us. Is it not me and you, Master?
And Elisha prayed and said, Lord, I pray thee, open his eyes. Which eye?
The spiritual eye. That he may see. And the Lord opened the eyes of the young man. And he saw, and behold, the mountain was full of horses and chariots of fire round about Elisha. Praise the Lord. Amen. I said number two. So how do agents of darkness use their powerful spiritual eyes to monitor their victims and then unleash evil on them? I said the agents of darkness, praise the Lord, have really used the power of the spiritual eyes to their own advantage. Because the spiritual eye enables them to look into the life of a man or a woman through the spiritual prism. They are able to monitor the progress of every department or all the departments of a man or a woman's life. They are able to monitor because they are using it to their advantage. But we, the children of God, that have the power, we have neglected the power. I say agents of darkness, through this medium, have the power to know what is going on in a man or a woman's life, destiny, marriage, home, family, business, job, career, investment, even health. And they are able to attack whatever they want to attack. Praise the Lord. I say, remember the story of Job. Satan tried to monitor and attack him, if not for the edge of God's divine protection around him. But immediately God removed the edge of protection, everything Job had came under attack. Amen. And were destroyed. Praise the Lord. I say this is how they use the power of their spiritual eyes. Amen. To see, to monitor, and to attack their victims. Praise the Lord. So finally, beloved, I say, knowing all this, how can you and your family be hid from the attacks of evil monitoring eyes? And I quickly open to Psalm 27. Hallelujah. Verse 5. Psalm 27, verse 5. This is the secret. Amen. The Bible says, for in the time of trouble, he shall hide me in his pavilion. We are going to raise up your two and say, my father, my father, my father. Arise, hide me and my family in the pavilion of your power. In the name of Jesus. My father, my father, my father. Arise and hide me. Hide my wife, hide my children. Hide members of this church. In the pavilion of your power, in the name of Jesus. Father, hide me, hide my wife, hide my children. Yes, in the pavilion of your power. And of course, if you look at, amen, hallelujah. If you look at Psalm 91, how can you be protected from these evil monitoring eyes? It's by dwelling in the secret place of the Most High. Praise the Lord. Say, he that dwelleth in the secret place of the Most High, Psalm 91, shall abide under the shadow of the Almighty. You will be under the shadow. When you are under the shadow of the Almighty, even you will be cut off from your leader. Because they cannot see into that shadow. They cannot see into the presence of God. They cannot see into the secret place of God. That's why the Bible says, in the presence of God, there is fullness of joy. Because when you are there, nothing can touch you. Praise the Lord. The Lord will help us in the mighty name of Jesus. But the problem is this. How do you now enter the secret place of the Most High? Of course, Psalm 24, you remember? Says, who shall ascend unto the hill of the Most High? Amen. Verse 3. Psalm 24, verse 3 says, who shall ascend into the hill of the Lord? Or who shall stand in his holy place? He that had clean hands. If you want to be hidden even from the evil monitoring eyes, your hands must be clean. Your heart must be pure. You must not lift your soul to vanity. You know, Solomon said, all vanity is vanity. Praise the Lord. Vanity upon vanity, all is vanity. Then not sworn deceitfully. Don't be a liar. What we are saying is you should be heaven conscious. You should live a holy life. You should live a righteous life. You should be humble. You should be broken. As long as these things are in your life, you will continue to dwell in the very presence of God. And because you are in the presence of God, no evil eye can see you, and no evil hand can touch you. Let us rise up. Let us begin to thank God. Let us begin to bless His holy name. Let us just worship Him. I'm seizing this opportunity once again. If you are hearing the sound of my voice, that this is Mountain of Fire Miracles Ministries, Tampa, Florida. We meet on this mountain every day. We are always having this hour of deliverance power program from 12 noon to 1 p.m. every day. We are here to pray. Praise the Lord. We also want you to come to join us in the church, because the Bible says, thou shalt not forsake the gathering of the saints. The Lord will help us in the mighty name of Jesus. Begin to cover yourself with the blood of Jesus. Say, from this very moment to the end of the year and even beyond, I cover myself, my family, my wife, my children, and every member of my family, whether nuclear or extended, either physical or spiritual, with the blood of Jesus. No evil shall befall any one of us. No evil eye shall see any one of us. Even as there's going to be a lot of traveling at the end of the month, as you move around, no evil eye shall see you, in the mighty name of Jesus. And those that are monitoring you, I cut off their radar in the name of Jesus. I destroy their monitoring mirrors in the name of Jesus. I set their evil satellites on fire in the mighty name of Jesus. You will see the end of this year in joy, in peace, in happiness, and you will go beyond it. You will even see 2020 by the power in the blood of Jesus. And you and every member of your household shall be happy for the rest of your lives. Thank you, Father, for in Jesus' name we have prayed. Let us take our tithe and offering very quickly. It is very good to always give an offering when you come for prayers. It is encouraged to do so. Praise the Lord. It's not compulsory, but it's encouraged. Praise the Lord. The Lord will help us in the mighty name of Jesus. I pray for someone, even as we are taking this offering, any power monitoring your finances for evil shall be destroyed in the name of Jesus. That your finance that is under attack, I let the power in the blood of Jesus, the resurrection power, begin to rescue your finances in the name of Jesus. It shall be well with you all the days of your life, in the mighty name of Jesus. Let us all rise up. Father, once again, we thank you for bringing us to this mountain this afternoon to cry to you. And we know that you have heard our prayers. Jeremiah chapter 33 verse 3 says, call unto me and I will answer you, and I will show you great and mighty things that you know nothing about. Father, we have called. We know you have answered. Father, even in our dreams, in our visions, revelations, Father, reveal to us the secret that will promote our lives and our destinies. In the name of Jesus. Father, even in our dreams, in our visions, arise in your power and destroy our enemies. In the name of Jesus. Thank you, Father, for this tithe and offering. Accept it in the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Enlarge the coast of your children. Devour their devourers. In the name of Jesus. Father, breathe upon their businesses, their investments, their jobs, and their career. In the name of Jesus, the Lord will continue to promote you. In the name of Jesus, it shall be well with you. You will enter 2020 in style. Amen. By the power in the blood of Jesus. Amen. Father, we thank you for everything. For in Jesus' name we pray. Even as your children go back to their places of work or wherever they are going, Father, take them safely to their destinations. Amen. Thank you, Father, for in Jesus' name we are prayed. Amen. Let us share the grace now. The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the sweet fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with us now and forevermore. Amen. Surely God's goodness and mercy shall follow us all the days of our lives, and we shall dwell in the house of the Lord forever and ever. Amen. Seven powerful hallelujah. Let's go. Hallelujah. 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 God bless you. Thank you for coming.